Hello everyone, welcome back to my channel Deep Understanding of Research Papers. Today in this tutorial I will explain the paper Memory Fusion Networks for Multi-View Sequential Learning. This paper is written by collaboration with three different universities, CMU, NTU Singapore and Institute of Politecnico National Mexico. So first I'll give you the overview of the paper. Then I'll explain what is multi-view or multi-model learning. Then I'll explain memory fusion networks. Then we will see some experiments done by the people from this paper, and then at the end we'll see some results. So the overview of the paper is it explains how multimodal learning can be applied to various problems like sentiment analysis, emotion recognition, and speaker trait analysis. This memory fusion network tries to learn the interaction between different modalities, for example, in a given video. This paper introduces this architecture, new architecture called memory fusion networks, to learn this cross-modal interaction between the domains. Then at the end, we will see they show that this paper actually outperforms all the current state of the art back in 2017, at least state of the art results on these three problems, which are sentiment analysis, emotion recognition, and speaker trait analysis. So first we will see what is multi-view or multimodal learning. So basically multimodal learning is about understanding the data from different modalities. For example, if you have a video and if you want to know or if you want to understand what is happening in the video, then video has different content. It has audio content, it has image content, and it also can have text content. So for example, if you are looking for an video of a person giving a review of a product, and if you want to understand what is his sentiment about the product after understanding the video or after watching the video, then we can use all these three modes to see or to get what is going to be the sentiment in this video, or we can say is the person liking the product, or is the person hating the product, or is it the product is okay kind of thing. So we can understand that, or we can understand this opinion of this product reviewed by this guy in three different modalities. So we can see the image content, or we can see his face and see how his expression varies. If he looks happy throughout the video, that means the review is going to be good, or the opinion about the product he's reviewing may be good. That's one modality, which is vision, obviously. And we have audio also. So we can apply some sort of algorithm which will understand understand the emotion coming out of the audio. And then also we can predict what is going to be the sentiment of this person, or what is going to be the opinion of the product reviewed by this person. So audio, you can see the pitch variation in the voice, or if he's really angry, or if he is very happy. So those kind of things we can predict from audio, which is called audio speech emotion recognition, which is a complete field. A lot of people are working only on that speech emotion recognition. And we have the text content also. So in the text content, by looking at the words he is speaking, the text content, by looking at the text content also, we can make prediction about the sentiment. For example, if the person says this product is the best, then we can say that this person is feeling good about the product, or his opinion is good about the product. So that is another modality. So you can analyze, or we can get the sentiment of this person using all these three modalities separately, but we can of course combine the representations coming out from image, audio and text, and we can expect that the results, the final results we are going to get, will be more accurate compared to analyzing the content using one stream or one view. One view could be, the view could be image, could be audio, it could be text. Doing the analysis on separate modes or separate view is another, is one thing, but if you can understand the entire video by combining features from all these three views and learning some sort of interaction, how the dynamics is happening between video and audio. If you can understand those dynamics and if you can model those dynamics, then we can get a better representation about the content or the video content compared to getting the representations or getting the features only by analyzing one stream separately. So that is the overall idea of this paper. So how do we combine the dynamics from all the modalities? In this video case, it's only three. Some other problem, it can be more or it can be less. So in this case, we have a video, and video can contain the words he is speaking, the audio, I mean the pitch variation or the intensity or the energy of the audio signal. And in the image, you can obviously see his expressions. So those are the different features. So how do we combine all these three dynamics which are happening in the video, or how do we combine these modalities, all three modalities, to get a better representation of the problem, so that we can model the problem very well and get a better accuracy. So so that was about it. For example, you can see a video here. So as you can see, in this video, the person expression is varying. That means she is very happy and she is saying the words like fantastic, amazing. And in the audio, you can see her pitch is varying a lot. It looks like she is very surprised or she is very happy. So for a human, it's very easy to understand these things. And of course, you can say she is very happy about the product and she is going to give a very good rating for this product. So how do we make the machine to understand all these three things and get a better representation so that it can predict the sentiment very well? So we will see that combining all these three things together can get a really good accuracy, and they show that, and particularly this architecture, which is a memory fusion network, can get a accuracy more than the state of the art as of that date in 2017. So now we'll see what is memory fusion network basically. So memory fusion network is basically, when you think of memory in deep learning or in neural network, it's LSTM, right? So so we have this architecture which consists of three different parts. So one is called system of LSTM. System of LSTM basically is a three different LSTM. It is three in our case because we are understanding video, but it would be different if you go to some other domain. For example, it can be four or five based on what is the problem you are trying to solve. So in this problem, we have three different LSTM. So LSTM, you can see this blue box in the row, three rows, right? So the three rows combined together is called system of LSTMs. So basically, we have three different streams. So one stream is audio, one stream is text, one stream is vision, which is images. So for each stream, we have one LSTM sequence, one LSTM, and when you unfold the LSTM over time, you will get this sequence. For example, at time t minus 1, t plus 2, t plus 3, so on, we have LSTMs here. So for example, this row, the top row in this system of LSTM block, belongs to encoding the audio features into LSTM. Basically, these are the cell states of the LSTM which we obtain after we pass the audio segments at that particular time to that LSTM. And in the middle, we have a stream, or we have LSTM, which is going to encode the vision part, which is basically it's a face features. So basically, it takes the face features and gets a cell state, which is CV t minus 1 at time t minus 1. And we also have text LSTM, which is C, it's called CL here. So basically it's L stands for language basically. So languages, or they could have put T here. T is again it's confusion between the upper the suffix and prefix. So basically L is again language. So LS, you can think of this stream as a text which is encoding the text. So we'll see what are the inputs for these LSTMs and what is the output dimensions, everything in the coming slides. So basically you can think of we have three modalities or three streams, and we are encoding each stream by one LSTM. So that is the system of LSTM, and we will see what is delta memory attention network and what is multi-view gated memory. So you could basically simply take these three representation, concatenate them together, and feed it on. I mean, you can just concatenate these representations together, and directly predict what is going to be the sentiment, right? But that is not going to give you. It's not going to give you a result which is going to be better than state of the art, but they have made some modifications to that thing, and they have shown that how do we understand this cross view. A cross view is basically views or the representations from different stream. So how do we combine that and get a better understanding of the dynamics happening in the stream, or how do we get the how do we get the for example if you take an example of, let's say, audio is CA and we have video. So how these two things are combined, or how these two things are correlated when this video is happening. So how a person's face expression changes when he says something. So how do we capture that? So that can be understood using this delta memory attention and multi-view gated memory. So we'll discuss these blocks in very detail in the coming slides. So first we will see so what is system of LSTM again. System of LSTM as is this one row is one LSTM starting from time slot 0. So at 0th time slot you get an image. Image is basically after we extract the face features, we get some dimensional face feature, we feed it to LSTM. So LSTM gives me the cell state. So that way we have so many LSTMs unfolded in time, and we encode the video, which is the image sequence, in one LSTM. Same way we encode the audio sequence in another LSTM and text sequence in another LSTM. So basically we have three different LSTM. We will see what is going to be the input to these LSTMs and what is the dimension, all of those things later. Next we'll see the delta memory attention network. So basically delta memory attention network, you can see there are three different words here. Delta basically it's nothing but difference. You can think of it as a difference between two different times, I mean delta. Then memory is there, then attention is there. So basically what's happening here is we are going to take the representations or cell state from two different times, t minus 1th and time t. So if you look at the cell state at t and cell state at t minus 1, we have three different cell states, one for each modality. So basically what we are going to do is we are going to take each of this. You can see here there's a box here, that box becomes these three blue blocks. So this is basically the one, this row is basically belongs to t minus 1 the time, and this row is a t the time, and each block is modalities vector feature, sorry, cell state. So this basically, this one box is here is one vector, and another box in another vector. So basically what we want to do is we want to come up with an attention vector which we'll get it by taking this entire block and feeding it to a small neural network. So basically the dimension which is going to go as input to this feed forward neural network as the dimension of 2DC. So where DC is basically sum of all the dimensions at particular time t. For example, if you take time t, so this language LSTM may give you 100 dimension vector, a vision network may give you 100 dimension, and for example audio may give you 100 dimension vector. So these three combined together what becomes DC. So DC is nothing but 300 in the example which I took, but we also have the time stamp t minus 1 here. since we have that, we'll have to make the input as 2DC. So it's 2DC, and that is what is going to go as an input, and the output is the same dimension, but it's called A, which is the softmax activated scores for each LSTM. So this AT is some sort of weighting vector. What we are going to do is we are going to multiply this output A, T minus 1 comma T minus 2, this block basically, with the actual this one, what actual the cell state. So what this is going to do is it's going to weight in the sense it's going to take some sort of weightage of these cell state dimensions, so that it preserves the ones which are more important when we do cross view attention, for example. So when we take different modalities vectors as a memory state, and we want to know which are the dimensions which are highly important for us to predict the sentiment, and we are going to do that by taking this which is called activated softmax activated score, and we are going to weight the actual cell states by this some sort of attention vector, so that we preserve the dimensions which are highly important and neglect the ones which are not important, right? So that is the job of our delta memory network, attention network. So delta is because of the name, we are taking vectors from T minus 1 and T. So that is about delta memory attention. Then we have another block called multi-view gated memory, as you can see here. So this multi-view gated memory basically this network basically takes care of cross view representation capturing. This basically captures how one mode and different other mode are kind of varying together when somebody speaks something, how his face expression, how his audio content, how the text or what he is saying are all related to each other. That will be captured by this network. But this network can capture at particular timestamp. But we want to capture things in sequence, because the person may say something and that may be relevant to what he is going to speak next. Right, so those things can be captured by using multi-view gated memory, which is basically some sort of memory which is going to keep track of what he spoke before and what is going to what he's saying now. So some sort of LSTM, but it's not exactly LSTM, so it's something similar to LSTM. So this basically has two different blocks. One is called reset and one is called update gate. Basically it's some sort of gate. So reset gate basically says how much of the content which I remembered previously, or how much of the cell state I will have to carry forward, and update says how much of the information I need to add to the current cell state, so that I predict better. So that is job about multi-view gated memory. And we have a feedback here, as you can see, it's some sort of LSTM which is going to keep writing the new information and discards the information which is not important for us. So basically this happens in three different stage. Basically we are going to feed our output from the delta memory attention network to a neural network and get something called update. So basically UT hat is an update, and that is going to tell us how much should we write, or how do we update the current cell state. And we have two different neural network which are called D gamma 1 and D gamma 2. So basically this output gamma 1 at particular time T basically takes the input from delta memory network and pass it through neural network, and we get delta gamma 1. Same thing we do it for the another network, and basically this one controls how much should we reset, and this one controls how much should we update, right? And the final update which we are going to get here, this green box, is going to be weightage of these two. So we are going to weight the previous update with what we have here, this is gamma 1t, and we multiply our the one which we calculated using this DU neural network with along with the tan h, so that we squash this values into the range of minus 1 and plus 1, and take the dot product of this vector with this vector, and that's going to be a new update vector. And this process keeps happening until we reach the last state, and whatever we get at the end, which is at capital T, we take that to predict what is going to be the sentiment of the network. So basically the overall idea of multi-view gated memory is to capture or to remember what happened before and what is happening currently. So basically it keeps updating its cell, keep updating its this UT, so that it knows where what to discard and what to keep. So some sort of LSTM, but not exactly LSTM, is something similar to LSTM. So that was about the gate memory fusion network. This is the whole idea of memory fusion network. Now we'll see some experimental setup, and we'll see some what are the problems they are trying to solve using this network. So basically they want to solve they have applied this architecture to see how they can analyze the sentiment in multimodal setup. For example, you have an opinion video, you have a review video basically, and you want to know whether the person is happy about the product he is reviewing or not, right? For example, that's one problem. And emotion recognition is obviously another problem, where you want to know what is the emotion of the person in the current video. There are different data sets for that. There is a EMOCAP data set for emotion recognition. They have used that here. Then there is a speaker trait analysis. That's another problem. So now we will see what are the input to the network and what is the output they are trying to extract. So basically we have three different modalities, right? We have speech, audio, and language. Language is basically text. So what we are going to do is we are going to take the words. For example, let's say he speaks something, we have a sentence, and we take the words, and for each word we get the glove embeddings, which are the 300 dimension vector. And vision, these are the features we are extracting: facial action units, face landmarks, head pose, gaze tracking, hawk features. So this will come up to 35 dimensions. But the question is, you can ask at what resolution they are capturing these features. In image, basically you will have to get these features at frame by frame. But if you get every one feature vector at one frame, then how will you make the dimensions of the language and the dimensions of, not the dimensions of the language, the time sequence of the language and the time sequence, how will you make that mapping between time sequence of the language and time sequence of the audio and time sequence of the image? So basically what we should do is, what they are doing is basically they are extracting this feature for every word. For example, if the word is lasting for, let's say, 1 second, so they extract the features for 1 second in the vision space or in the image domain, and they average all the features and they get one vector, which is going to be like one vector they are getting for word embedding. And the same thing happens in the audio also. They are extracting features for every 10 milliseconds, but they average all of them to get one feature vector for at word level. So for example, if somebody may speak one word for 3 seconds, one word for, let's say, 2 seconds, and whatever the features they get for those 2 seconds clip, they average them and get a single vector. So basically they use all these features for speech, they use capsule coefficient, pitch tracking, voiced unvoiced features, glottal source parameter, peak slope parameters, and maxima dispersion quotients. So they are totally, there is 34. So those are the input to the network, and obviously when they feed this, they get the cell state, and what we know what happens after the cell state. So the cell state output is going to go to the delta memory fusion network, and then memory attention network, and then it's going to go to the multi-view gated memory, and the end of the last state of the multi-view gated memory is going to go to the softmax, where we predict whether this, what is the sentiment of this video, right? So that's what the final goal is. So I am going to show you one results on CMU MOSI sentiment data set, which is a recent data set. There is another data set which came recently, which is called MOSI with SCIUI, and there are a lot of other problems they have done, a lot of other things they have done. They have done analysis of emotion on EMOCAP data set, they have done speaker trait analysis. All those results are there. It's a big list of or big table. I was not able to put that entire table in this, but I have put only one problems results, and I'll show you. They are showing that basically they are beating the state of the art actually. So they had these two systems, state of the art 1, 2, which are giving this sort of results. Now they use MFN, which is memory fusion network, and they have shown it on different versions of MFN. Basically, MFN L says we are going to use only the language part, which is the only text. And what is going to be the accuracy? It's a binary accuracy. They are getting 73%, which is good. Which is almost close to the state of the art 2 paper. Then if they add or if they use only audio content, they get 53% accuracy, which is not good. And if they use only vision, they get 55% accuracy, which is not again not good compared to these two. But you can see here that using only text, you get a lot of, we get very good accuracy. And another experiment where they show MFN with no delta. So basically, they use only one vector or one at a particular time t. They feed it to DMN and memory gated multi-view gated network. But if they do that, they get an improvement over state of the art by 1%. And if they don't use multi-view gated memory network, and they get 76.5. But if they use all of them together, they get 77, which is actually the state of the art results. So this is actually really good, and this is actually 2017 paper, but today they have a different data set, which is like much bigger than this CMU MOSI data set, and they have around they are 10 times bigger than what they have in MOSI. It's another data set which is similar to this. It has come already, and they also show a really good accuracy, and they have made different algorithms. I think the same author, the first author, has written 2, 3, 4 or at least 2 algorithms which are kind of better than this memory fusion network. Check them out, and they're really good. And thank you so much for watching this video.